So a very good morning to all of you and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams of central government or of the state government. So as you all know, PIB is the most authentic source if I talk about the current affairs. So we have to focus on every relevant news from PIB. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any query. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan, which is in news these days. So the question is, under PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan, an empowered group of secretaries will be formed to review and monitor the implementation of the plan. Who will be the head of this group? See, National Master Plan, PM Gati Shakti, we have discussed recently, 3-4 videos back. So we will not discuss the same things because that will be repetition. So it is in news once again because now the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved this. Okay? इसको अप्रूव कर दिया है एंड दे हैव आल्सो रिलीज्ड सम इंप्लीमेंटेशन प्रोग्राम हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस दे हैव रिलीज्ड इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग दैट सो वी विल डिस्कस दैट पार्ट ओनली सो द कैबिनेट कमिटी ऑन इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स हैज अप्रूव्ड द पीएम गति शक्ति नेशनल मास्टर प्लान एंड दे हैव आल्सो रिलीज्ड द इंप्लीमेंटेशन फ्रेमवर्क अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस फ्रेमवर्क देयर विल बी 3 ग्रुप्स दैट दे आर गोइंग टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूट 3 ग्रुप्स बनाए जाएंगे नंबर 1 इज द एम्पावर्ड ग्रुप ऑफ सेक्रेटरीज Empowered group of secretaries. Then we have network planning group. Number 2 is network planning group, and number 3 is the technical support unit. So these 3 groups will be constituted to implement the PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan. Now talking about these groups, so if I talk about EGOS first, which is empowered group of secretaries. So do remember, it's a very important fact that this empowered group of secretaries will be headed by the Cabinet Secretary of India. And it will consist of secretaries from 18 ministries. इसमें 18 ministry के secretaries होंगे and it will be headed by cabinet secretary. ठीक है, and who is the current cabinet secretary of India? It's Mr. Rajiv Gauba. Rajiv Gauba is the current cabinet secretary of India. And this empowered group of secretaries will review and monitor the implementation of the plan, and they will also have the responsibility of designing the frameworks and norms for implementation of this plan. Okay. Now talking about NPG. अगर हम NPG की बात करते हैं, network planning group. So this group will assist the empowered group of secretaries in implementation of the plan, and it will consist of the network planning wing of respective infrastructure ministries. जो network planning wing है of the infrastructure ministries, उनके जो heads होंगे वो इसके member होंगे. Okay, the members are who? Members कौन होंगे इसके? The head of the network planning wing of respective infrastructure ministries. This is what? Network planning group. Now talking about technical support unit. So this unit, guys, will be constituted to provide the expertise of the domain experts, and in this committee various persons from their domain expertise will be included. Like for example, from aviation there will be some people, from aviation there will be some experts, from oil and gas, from coal, from IT, is tarike se from every infrastructure sector there will be inclusion of experts so that they can provide their expertise in implementation of this particular plan. Okay, so this they have provided information regarding the implementation framework. So now let's come back to the question. The question is regarding who will be the head of this group, which is empowered group of secretaries. So as we discussed, Cabinet Secretary of India will be heading this empowered group of secretaries. So option D is the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2, which is regarding a report. According to the report released by Lancet titled 2021 report on health and climate change, code red for a healthy future. This is the title of report. India's vulnerability to the extremes of heat was 15% higher in 2019 as compared to 1990. So India ke upar heat ka bahut zyada effect hai. As per this report, India is among 5 countries where vulnerable populations had the highest exposure to heat waves. India un 5 countries mein se hai jahan pe जो पॉपुलेशन है उनके पास सबसे ज्यादा एक्सपोजर है हीट वेव्स का. द क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट द अदर फोर, बाकी जो चार बज की उनमें से कौन नहीं है. ऑल राइट, सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस रिपोर्ट. रिमेंबर द टाइटल ऑफ दिस रिपोर्ट, 2021 रिपोर्ट ऑन हेल्थ एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज, कोड रेड फॉर अ हेल्दी फ्यूचर, एंड दिस हैज बीन रिलीज बाय लैंसेट. लैंसेट ने इसको रिलीज किया है. नाउ दीज आर सम ऑफ द की हाइलाइट्स ऑफ दिस रिपोर्ट. पहली हाईलाइट तो हमें क्वेश्चन में मिल गई दैट इंडियाज वल्नरेबिलिटी टू द एक्सट्रीम ऑफ हीट वाज 15% हायर एज कम्पेयर टू द ईयर 1990. 15% ज्यादा था एज कम्पेयर टू 1990. नंबर टू, इंडिया एंड ब्राजील, द टू कंट्रीज इंडिया एंड ब्राजील रजिस्टर्ड द बिगेस्ट एब्सोल्यूट इंक्रीज इन हीट रिलेटेड डेथ्स बिटवीन 2018 एंड 19. इंडिया और ब्राजील में एब्सोल्यूट इंक्रीज हुआ है सबसे ज्यादा विद रिस्पेक्ट टू हीट रिलेटेड डेथ्स इन द ईयर 2018 एंड 19. Number three, heat-related mortality for people who are more than 65 years has also been increased and it has reached a record high of almost 3,45,000 deaths globally in the year 2019. And if we compare this to the year 2000 to 2005 average, then it is 80.6% higher. 80.6% ज़्यादा है, which is a very huge number. ठीक है, लगभग हम 100% की तरफ पहुंचने वाले हैं पिछले 20 सालों के 15 सालों के अंतराल में. राइट, वी आर अबाउट टू रीच 100% विद इन अ गैप ऑफ 15%. सो यू कैन 15 इयर्स. सो यू कैन सी हीट इज अ वेरी, यू नो, द ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, बेसिकली द ग्लोबल वार्मिंग इज नाउ क्रिएटिंग सो मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स फॉर अस. नाउ टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट, सो द फाइव कंट्रीज इंडिया, चाइना, इंडोनेशिया, इजिप्ट एंड नाइजीरिया, देयर पॉपुलेशन हैव फेस्ड द हाइएस्ट एक्सपोजर टू हीट वेव. सबसे ज्यादा पांच कंट्रीज ये हैं जहां पे पॉपुलेशन को एक्सपोजर मिला है हीट वेव से. देन वार्म टेम्परेचर्स आर ऑल्सो इफेक्टिंग द यील्ड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मेजर स्टेपल क्रॉप्स, जो बहुत सारी खाने वाली क्रॉप्स हैं, सीरियल्स हैं, उनके ऊपर भी हीट का काफी ज्यादा इफेक्ट है. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 6% रिडक्शन फॉर मेज, 3% फॉर विंटर वीट, 5.4% फॉर सोयाबीन, 1.8% फॉर राइस इन 2020. इफ वी कंपेयर द एवरेज ऑफ 1981 टू 2010, सो यू कैन सी हीट हैज अ डेटरेटिंग इफेक्ट ऑन द स्टेपल क्रॉप्स ऑल्सो, ऑन द क्रॉप्स ऑल्सो, ऑन द एग्रीकल्चर ऑल्सो. ऑलराइट, एंड ऑल्सो इन द ईयर 2020 अप टू 9% ऑफ द ग्लोबल लैंड सर्फेस वॉज इम्पैक्टेड बाई एक्सट्रीम ड्रॉट एज कम्पेयर टू 13% if I talk about the year 1950 to 1999. So basically in each and every aspect of society, of life, the heat has a devastating effect on all of us. So we have to control this heat. Now let's come back to the question. We have to identify which of the following is not those five countries where population has the highest exposure of heat waves. So India is one, China, Indonesia, Egypt and Nigeria. The correct answer will be what? Option D. Pakistan is not one among those five countries jahan pe sabse zyada exposure tha. All right. Moving ahead to question number 3, which is regarding the production gap report. So which of the following organizations has released the production gap report 2021, which assesses the gap between the government's plan to produce energy from fossil fuels and their commitments to reduce the use of fossil fuels so that they can achieve the commitments of the Paris Agreement. ठीक है, so किस organisation ने इसको release किया है? Now UNEP has released the production gap report 2021. UNEP is headquartered in Nairobi. Nairobi of course is in Kenya, and who is the chief of UNEP? It's Inger Andersen. Inger Andersen is the chief of UNEP and she is from Denmark. All right. Now this report assesses the gap between the government's plan to produce energy from fossil fuels to what they have committed to reduce the use of fossil fuels. जितना उन्होंने commit किया है कि हम कम करेंगे और जितना वो plan कर रहे हैं that they are going to produce with the help of fossil fuels, उसमें जो gap है उसको ये report assess करता है. And the very first edition of this report was released in the year 2019. Now talking about this report, so remember as per this report, the government across the world, government across this world are still planning to produce more than double the amount of fossil fuels by the year 2030, then that would be consistent with limiting global warming टू 1.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस। ठीक है, तो देख रहे हो जितना कमिटमेंट दिया है उससे डबल तो प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं। सो हाउ वी कुड बी एबल टू कंट्रोल द ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, हो ही नहीं सकता। ठीक है, देन द गवर्नमेंट्स आर ऑल्सो प्लानिंग टू इंक्रीज फॉसिल फ्यूल प्रोडक्शन बाय 45% इन 2030, विच इज वॉट दैट देन वॉट वुड बी कंसिस्टेंट विद द लिमिटिंग ग्लोबल वार्मिंग टू 2 डिग्री सेल्सियस। और पेरिस एग्रीमेंट ने बोला है कि भाई 1.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस से कंट्रोल करके रखो, वरना तो हो जाएगा काम, गड़बड़ हो जाएगी। And this report details the government's strategy, supports and plan for fossil fuel production in 15 major fossil fuel energy producing countries. All right. So this was about this report, and now let's come back to the question. So the correct answer will be what? UNEP option B, because UNEP has released this production gap report 2021. और इसमें से report में से question यही आएगा, which of the following organizations has released? Because in detail इसमें से MCQ पूछना is quite difficult. Question number 4. Which of the following organizations has developed web-based project management portal for military engineering services, which will enable real-time monitoring of projects from its inception to completion? Now, in this particular news also, only this question could be asked. केवल यही question पूछा जा सकता है, इसके अलावा कोई question नहीं पूछा जाएगा. So the news is that Minister of Defence Mr. Rajnath Singh, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Lucknow, has launched web-based project management portal for military engineering service, and this portal will provide will enable the real-time monitoring of projects from its beginning to its end, from its inception to its end. Okay, and this has been developed, this is important, this portal has been developed by Bhaskaracharya National Institute for Space Application and Geo Informatics, which is located in Gujarat. Okay, केवल यही क्वेश्चन आएगा, तो याद रखना, this web-based project portal has been launched by BISACN, alright, which is located in Gujarat. So this was about this news only. इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Option C, BISACN is the correct answer. BISACN, ठीक है? Moving कहीं कहीं पे BISAC G भी लिखा होता है, तो please do not get confused. एक ही बात है, BISAC की जो official website है, उसपे BISACN है. That's why I have used BISACN here. Now this question is important for the upcoming NABARD exam. NABARD mains का जो एग्जाम आ रहा है उसके लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है. लेट मी टेल यू दिस फर्स्ट, बाकी में भी पूछा जा सकता है, बट नॉट सो मच इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अदर एग्जाम. इट इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर NABARD mains अपकमिंग, या फिर अगले 2022 के लिए भी. सो अ मेडिसिन नेम मैस्टिरैक हैज बीन डेवलप्ड बाय नेशनल इनोवेशन फाउंडेशन. दिस नेशनल इनोवेशन फाउंडेशन वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, विच इज हेडेड बाय डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सिंह ऑफकोर्स, फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ मैस्टिटिस. Mastitis is a disease, and for its treatment, a new medicine, Mastirec, has been launched. So the question is, the disease is an infectious disease of DASH. Fill the gap. Okay. See, in NABARD syllabus, we also have animal husbandry. Animal husbandry bhi hai. So this question can be asked under this heading of animal husbandry. All right. Now, mastitis is an infectious disease of dairy cattle. Option E. Dairy cattle is the correct answer. Do you remember the name of disease? अब क्वेश्चन ये ना पूछ के ये भी पूछा जा सकता है, मैस्टिटिस डिजीज इज रिलेटेड टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. सो डेयरी कैटल इन दैट केस वुड बी अगेन द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑलराइट, मूविंग अहेड टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फाउंडेशंस हैज डेवलप्ड अ रेस्ट हाउस नेम्ड एज विश्राम सदन एट नेशनल कैंसर इंस्टीट्यूट इन झज्जर कैंपस ऑफ एम्स. वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन, कुड बी आस्क्ड ओनली इन वन मार्क, एक मार्क्स में ही आ सकता है ये क्वेश्चन. And no need to go into the details of this Vishram Sadan. This is nothing but a rest house for the people who are coming for their treatment. Not the people who are coming for treatment, the families of those who are coming for their treatment. Agar main bimar hu, meri family ka koi person mere saath gaya hai, then he has to stay somewhere. So rather than sadak pe sona or roadside sona ya hospital mein kahin pe bhi bistar laga ke sone ke bajaye, they can have rest at this Vishram Sadan, this rest house, which has been developed by Infosys Foundation. Option B, Infosys Foundation is the correct answer. And who is the CEO of Infosys, by the way? Salil Parekh. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.